Hello and welcome to this video presentation from the Urban Penguin, and my name is Andrew Mallett. We're going to be taking a look at using SED to extract HTML tags from a web page. We'll start off though, rather than using HTML tags, we'll start off looking at simple characters, so removing B and G's from a file. So if we take a look at a sample file that I've got, so big.txt, we can see there the text. So this is a document to show that the word big can delete from this page. Not just big, we can search for B and delete all until the letter G, and then see what I mean. So we're going to set a said search string to start at the word B and delete all characters up to and including the word G. So let's see how we would do that. So SED, minus E for our expression, and then in quotes, the string that we're going to be searching for. So S for search. So we're going to search for the letter B. And then we want to end when we find the letter G. So square brackets and then starting at the letter G. So we search B through to G, really. And we want to then include all of those characters. So using the asterisk G. So we're searching for B through to G and including all of the characters up to and including the character G. And then we want to look at what we want to replace them with. So we're replacing them with nothing. So there's no characters, an empty string in my second argument for said. And then I'm using G for global. So I want to search for B through to G and replace it with nothing globally from my file big.txt. Now when we have a look at the output, we can see that the word big has been removed, but not just the word big. So we see big has been removed from the first line, the second line, but then on the third line, everything from B until the letter G has been deleted. And then, of course, the last line remains untouched. See what I mean? So hopefully this was a simple demonstration. It's no different when we start looking at HTML tags, but of course we're searching for the less than and the greater than symbol. So if we look at the web page, we see it's a pretty standard web page, albeit small. So we can adjust then our syntax to look for the less than symbol instead of B. Searching for then the next greater than symbol and removing everything in between the less than and greater than symbols. Still replacing it with nothing and still globally in the file. Of course, we need to do this for our web page, and voila, there we have it, the HTML tags removed. And although it might look a little bit of a nightmare when we set this up, of course, once you have it set up once, it's always set up. So hopefully this has given you a little insight into using the stream editor SED and some good reasons to use Linux at the command line. Thank you very much for visiting.